Roll camera. Action, action, action.
Blue is definitely an action-packed film.
Especially underwater.
Sharks going through here and there.
Escape and gunfight.
Huge explosion.
It's got a bit of romance, a bit of adventure. It's got lots of action and a bit of danger.
Blue is an ambitious project. It is a project where vision of lots of people have come together.
Basically, the idea was a very thin line.
छोटी मोटी मछलियाँ पकड़ने से क्या होगा सेठ जी? कोई ट्रेजर वेजर ढूंढते हैं यार?
The way Thonik was thinking of how to go ahead and shoot it was the thing which attracted me towards the film.
We had motorcycles chasing on moving trains. We had a large portion of underwater action. And we had live sharks.
30 to 40 sharks at the same time. You just surround them, you're in their world, you're at their mercy.
There's something incredibly scary about being able to see these animals in their natural habitat.
Welcome to the Bahamas, man.
Listen, you have to do behind the scenes. You have to ask the stars the question, not...
Can you see me now?
Action! Tony and I set about designing the action, and it was broken into several shoot schedules. The first being underwater.
Action normally is very difficult shooting on land. In underwater, it is twofold the trouble.
Perform underwater stunts.
Everybody ready?
And to do fights, it's quite difficult.
It wasn't easy like beating up somebody underwater. It's made to look easy. You're floating, so how do you hold somebody and not have your feet on the ground? They had to like kind of put weights on us.
The weight belt is to prevent you from floating up.
The weight, very comfortable. Okay, Mira, one second, we should have on my with the glass. It's amazing.
To have action underwater and to execute it in a proper way is the main thing.
Crew that we had, they were so particular that nothing got harmed.
For many of the safety people who were there to ensure the primary actor's safety.
The most difficult underwater portions have been done by Mr. Kumar.
We're from my next dive now.
That's the climax fight where Arav fights with the henchmen.
Akshay and the henchmen he's fighting take one another's masks off.
He exploded off the bottom to attack one of his enemies, and he hit his head on a very sharp object on the wreck.
Okay, so this is the cut which I got while shooting. I saw blood coming out, and everybody panicked, and they had to take me up as soon as possible.
The first reaction when you hurt here, you take a deep breath. I don't know how he managed to control that, and there were sharks all around and there was blood. He started walking towards me and I thought that's the end of my movie. But he just came up and said, did you get the take? And I said, yes, sir. He said, do you want one more? I said, no, sir. And that was it.
There was this little funny mop sequence where I'm trying to do like a witch kind of wizard thing underwater. Sharks got really attracted because the mop had these like kind of, you know, shark game, and you had to like kind of grapple with them.
Sharks are, they're not predictable fishes.
There's an opening scene in the film where Mr. Kumar and Mr. Dutt are both fighting band of the shark. We kept training with a real live shark.
On the day of the shoot, the shark we got was not so well behaved and decided to bite Mr. Siddharth.
Fortunately for us, the man had his presence of mind at that time and saved himself.
There was a huge explosion they make over the water. And they told me to swim under this water and come out.
The fire, the heat of that was so tremendous that Mr. Kumari wanted to come up, couldn't come up. So he had to swim almost for about 150 meters before he could come up and breathe the air.
It took us about, I think, a week of preparation to get ready to blow my house up, to blow it to smithereens.
It was a very large house, very well built by the production designer, and my job was to make sure it was destroyed.
To pull off something like that is a big thing because the whole house is exploding from the inside.
I have to give due credit to the action team, to James Babalik, our action director. They worked really, really hard.
Let my momentum come over your body and then throw me.
Zayed's incredibly enthusiastic. Zayed was on a motorcycle a lot.
The bridge portion, I wanted to shoot on a bridge called Ramadri. We approached the police, but they didn't grant us the necessary permits to shoot out there, so we decided to shoot it more like guerrilla style. We took an ultimate arm where Lakshman was operating that.
The ultimate arm is kind of a device, you know, it's a 14-foot crane mounted on SUV.
It's one thing riding a bike dangerously. It's another thing riding a bike dangerously with a camera 4 feet away from you at all points in time.
This freeway chase was very important to Tony. It involved a huge amount of traffic, a bridge, semi-trucks.
There was one sequence where there's a semi-truck which flips over, and there were mag wheels in that. The fear was we didn't know how high or how far the mag wheels would go. When the truck flipped open, it just went across all over the place.
As soon as that explosion happened, I could just feel like this fire and this heat. My only wish was, I have to get out of this, I have to get out of this, I have to get out of this.
3, 2, 1, action! Oh, yes!
Woo! General Asian stuntmen, they have a completely different body language of jumping and doing things. I had to do my own stunts.
Got the sequence ready to go. We're ready to shoot it. Lakshman has everything framed. Right before we go, Zayed walks up to me and says, I'm going to do this myself. Huh?
James will be calling bang, 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 bang.
And I convinced James, who was our action director, who's this Hollywood guy who's just totally freaks out when his actors have to do it on their own.
The bullet hits, shattering glass all around him. He runs down the balcony and jumps up.
This place we had to shoot in the rubber field.
Leaves and mud don't exactly make the best ground terrain for bikes.
It was really tough to like kind of get onto the bike and do your little skids and your wheelies.
It was like walking on marbles.
You give bike tanki mein petrol hogi aur visfot hone ki sambhavna hai. So jo bhi hai apni jagah pe hi rahiye jab tak hum log na bole ke short ho.
I went up to James and I said, I don't like this stuff. I want it to be bigger. I want the bike to ram on the tree. I want the man to fly, hit the tree, the bike to fall on top of him.
Good and look.
Bing!
Just when we thought it was over, Tony's like, oh, now we have to jump off a train. I said, do I have to jump off a train?
We rehearsed it for a week, but on the actual day with the moving train, it's totally different.
I It freaked me out because apparently the train had to be moving when I jumped.
I think it was the second or third take where Zayd got it bang on.
I think Akshay was also freaked out when he had to do a couple of stunts, but you know, I think he did it fantastically.
आदमी अपने आप से भाग सकता है अपनी किस्मत से नहीं. I'm playing a grey character
who's a playboy, always been a womanizer. His goal in life is money. He's very greedy.
हमें समुंदर के अंदर जाके treasure को लेके आना है.
Hook or by crook, he's going to get to it.
And after that, we all be rich.
Mr. Dutt's character in the film is Sagar. He's the diver. He loves the water.
दुनिया की कोई भी लालच होना मुझे वहाँ जाने के लिए मजबूर नहीं कर सकती.
It's about his friends. It's about his desertion. It's about his brother.
You have a damn plan.
Yes, boy. I have a plan.
Zayd plays a character who's very fearless, who does things very rashly, doesn't use his mind, works by his heart. Lara Dutta plays Mona in the film.
To fear Mona pay agaya. Mona ke bare main kuch bhi bola na to sirha nichi jayega.
I play a sea lion trainer.
She is Mr. Dutt's romantic love interest in the film.
The day with the dolphins was amazing.
The dolphins were coming and mimicking them.
If they decide that they actually really like you, you're doomed, because then they're slamming into your side affectionately. It was absolutely incredible. But I have to say, I think one of my toughest days in the water was this amazing song sequence that we were filming. I felt like a circus animal.
That's Saab removing rings from his mouth and you just going inside the ring and coming out.
Firstly, I just couldn't believe you could blow a bubble in the water.
It was amazing. The shot looks fantastic on screen.
Well, in my life, I would never be able to experience something like shooting with Seabob. Seabob is a kind of underwater motorcycle.
Such an interesting machine, and especially riding it. And you know, just going down and in the water and through the reefs.
बस की बहुत मीनिंगफुल लिरिक्स लिखे हैं उसने चिगी विगी विद मी.
आई हैव नो क्लू व्हाट चिगी विगी स्टैंड्स फॉर.
चिगी विगी विद मी कैन मीन किस मी, हैव फन विद मी. आई एम मोर ऑब्सीन मीनिंग्स व्हिच आई एम शो एंथनी हैड इन माइंड.
I've been very influenced by Nasir Hussain films where you would have a 3-minute song where the song kept changing throughout. Every man who ever sees me wants to hold my
hand and be the one who gets me to see all I do. A.R. Rahman, amazing.
We tried to amalgamate two songs in one, so the moment Akshay comes in, it's the same beat but we added a Punjabi groove to that.
जब मैं और टोनी इस सॉन्ग के बारे में डिस्कस कर रहे थे तो हमने डिसाइड किया कि इस गाने में ज़्यादा कलर्स यूज नहीं करेंगे. सो आई डिसाइडेड टू प्ले विद वेरियस शेड्स ऑफ ब्लू.
अब्बास केम विद द आइडिया ऑफ खातून के खिदमत में खिलाड़ी की एक ख्वाहिश. व्हिच ही फेल्ट द यूज ऑफ केज वाज वेरी नाइस.
फारा इज अ बिग कैरेक्टर but a big heart at the same time, and to work with her on set was really, really something else.
जब मुझे एंथनी ने कहा कि इस गाने में काइली मिनोग होने वाली है, so obviously ये गाना was choreographed to suit Kylie's style. एंड में जब अक्षय एंड Zayed and everyone joins in and starts doing bhangra. Tab humne Kylie ko bhi bhangra karwaya and she was very easy with it and she was loving doing the Bollywood stuff.
Mr. Dutt has danced very freely in the song because his fans know him to dance a certain way. He's always known to enjoy himself in a song, which is what when you see he's really having a good time in the song.
The director Anthony D'Souza, he's doing something that's really fresh, very interesting for a Bollywood film, and he's pushing the barriers. And I'm really glad that he wanted me to be part of it.
Fikrana, I really don't know what it means.
I heard Fikrana, I was really excited. It was not a song that I was originally supposed to be in, so I was very jealous.
Fikrana means befikar hoke jeena.
I think it's a beautiful track.
It's a really catchy tune, it's also got a really great energy to it. Lyrics are really quite edgy, they're quite fun, they're young.
Why should we care about what other people think when we're in love?
Fikrana ho ke hum jiye, khama kha hum jiye.
I think that's a very beautiful line in its term.
Sounds fantastic. It's a new age anthem, I think. Ahmed is a brilliant choreographer. He's done some fantastic work. The first time I heard it, I couldn't understand what language they were singing in, forget what the words were. Then when I figured out that they were singing in Punjabi, I thought it was a very cool idea.
It's very grunge rock.
Very manly kind of attitude.
It's a very rebellious track.
Like, I don't care a damn.
I think A.R. Rahman has given us the perfect theme song for Blue.
The feel is always very loud.
Shout everyone.
Right from the main principal artist to the last background dancer.
When we got onto the set and I saw the dancers there, wow, they want me to keep, you know, pace with these guys.
Dancing format is not typical in this song.
It's more like chhati bahar karke, you're dancing around.
It gives you the energy ki chalo rakhi isko marte.
Very tough attitude, which is supposed to be called crumb.
Shooting this song was a little difficult because the energy level till the last shot had to be of that high.
I think this is the first release of Rahman's after the Oscar. Working with Rahman, I just learned one thing, which I think the most important thing I've learned to date. If it is conventional, don't do it. If it's different, go for it. Try and break the rule at every given time.
Blue is definitely an action-packed film, the kind of action that you've never seen on the Indian screen before.
This is going to be a historic movie.
Blue is an entertainer. I just hope it entertains people more than anything else.